Hi guys, today we'll go back in time because we'll play Clash Royale in black and white. Since like a month I use on my phone different modes and one of the options I have selected is black and white screen. It is set to reduce distractions. I played few Clash Royale matches with it turned on and it's really hard. Because we are going back in time, we'll play with one of the oldest Clash Royale decks which used to be a meta back in the day. Here is the classic logbait. Let's go play few ranked games and see if the past will dominate the present. Here we go, as I said, we have black and white screen, and like it's harder since you don't see any colors, but the biggest problem I have discovered so far is distinguishing your units from your opponent's units. Sometimes when all of them run together you don't know anymore which ones are yours and which are not, but okay, you'll see what I mean in a moment. So we will start with Goblin Barrel and our opponent will have Firecracker, Goblin Gang and also Barbarian Barrel. So it's fast cycle cheap deck, pretty much like it's similar to ours, right? Because Classic Logbait is also a cycle deck. And wait, can we play Rocket immediately? That will be a really great start, because we'll kill that witch, we'll get some tower damage with Rocket, and we have also... Whoa, and okay, that Spear Goblins even force out their Rocket... their arrows. But unfortunately, right now he'll go with Elixir Golem and Bats. So I will play Princess at back. But hey, we should defend easily. I think that I will also play Knight, because like... we'll get some elixirs back from that defense, because that elixir golem will give us few elixirs. And now we can counter push with... okay, I don't know, I think that goblin barrel was not the greatest play. Okay, especially that... like, okay, he would play that barbarian barrel anyway. But wait, I think that one of the goblins stayed alive, because that firecracker shoots someone who was behind their tower. So okay, that was great. Now let's play lock, and I think that ice spirit should stab that witch. I can always play... okay, that was not the greatest play, but okay, we'll take only like, that was 2 or 3 witch shots, and now, okay, he does play arrows, let's go with Goblin Gang. He will respond with his own Goblin Gang, but that's great for us. Wait, and our Goblin Gang will even win, even though we were fighting on his side of the map. Okay, I have no idea how it happened, but it's only better for us. And now, I don't think that this push made a lot of sense, because now I have to defend Mini P.E.K.K.A. with Bats and all the other stuff. So I need to play like Goblin Gang, and now he will play arrows and hit nearly everything, but I think that he has to respond to that goblins, okay. So he played Goblin Gang, we have... okay, we played Lock and we also hit for a Cracker. Great value. Now let's play Goblin Barrel to the side, so if he will play Barbarian Barrel in the middle, he will miss one of the goblins, but okay. If you will play Wish just like that, I play Rocket and get massive value from it every time. So yeah, and basically, that's the thing I'm like, whenever I play against Classic Logbait, that's the thing I always forgot. I always forget. It's like, okay, I'm playing against Classic Logbait, so they have Rocket for sure. So I can't play units behind my tower. And then I kind of forget about that, and in the meantime I play like my Hunter behind my King Tower or something, and then my opponent just plays Rocket, and I am like, yeah, I shouldn't have played that. But okay, in the meantime, we won our first match pretty easily, and let's go for another one. Okay, here we have second match, and the best thing is that in the previous match, I wasn't even really focused because I was commentating a lot. And okay, wow, our opponent will have Mega Knight. I don't think it's, like, okay, maybe it's not such a bad matchup because we have Inferno Tower, for example, and also Knight. But first we need to get it in our starting hand, like in our hand. And okay, he'll have Mega Knight Hog Rider. So two win conditions, and we have only one Inferno Tower. So it might be hard later on, but okay, we'll stop that Mega Knight, we don't have to play anything else. I was hoping that that princess will still alive because, like, okay, but it didn't happen. Now he'll click his Golden Knight ability and I will not defend that with anything. Or maybe, okay, I should have played Knight. Okay, that's way more damage than I thought. I thought that he'll hit my tower like 2 or maybe 3 times, but it turned out to be way more than that. So okay, after first minute we are not winning, but it's still close, and we'll definitely fight for the win. And he'll have Wizard, he played that at back. Boom! Amazing Cracked value once again. I hope that I hit him. Yes, I did it. And yeah, that's only -1 elixir trade, but I get such a huge amount of tower damage, and also right now that princess shot his tower 2 times because that Mega Knight was really close to his tower, And great, okay, even though our Inferno Tower... Okay, it will not get even destroyed right now. I wanted to say that even if you'd like to play immediately with Hog Rider, we still have Goblin Gang, we have Ice Spirit, we have even Log to stop it, so... We have many different responses, and I don't think that he will be able to win this match. Okay, he has got Mirror Mega Knight. That's a little bit more scary, but I think that we should still be able to defend that. If he wants to go with Hog Rider the other side, we go just for Goblin Gang. I hope he will not play Arrows here. Okay, he will not do that. Okay, or he will, but it's just too late. So now... Okay, that Mega Knight will jump on my tower. Okay, I didn't play that in time. And he has got Mega Mini P.E.K.K.A. on the other side of the arena. Wait, it's not great, but we'll take two Mini P.E.K.K.A. hits. And come on, play Wizard at back. I know you won't. I know you won't. Okay, he will play Mega Knight instead. I was hoping that I will get another amazing Cracked value. But okay, it will not happen this time. I think that I will play Goblin Gang once the Golden Knight crosses the river. And now we need to get back to our Knight. Okay, that wasn't the greatest Goblin Gang of my life, but now I need to play Inferno Tower. Oh no. Oh no, it did not came in down. It did not came down in time, and now I will lose two towers in a... No, please, no, we need to defend that. Okay, 51 HP. If we take his tower and somehow defend both of our... Maybe we'll win. Come on, wait, Rocket. He doesn't have any spells. He doesn't have any spells, 51 HP. Oh wow, okay. To be fair, I didn't expect to win that one. I thought that he will play some arrows or something, but maybe he didn't have them in cycle, and somehow we won that match too. Quick sip of water. We are on a win streak, two wins in a row, and now we'll play against Ghost Crown. Okay, so I think that once we'll destroy his towers, then their towers will be a ghost. So yeah, hopefully we'll win also this match. And he will have also Mega Knight, just like our previous opponent, and also Tornado, so a little bit different deck, but yeah, it's a Mega Knight deck, so it will be similar. And okay, so he will have Tornado, probably instead of Arrows, and also Musketeer instead of Wizard. Unfortunately, I cannot play that Knight later, because I wanted to, like, let his Musketeer on my side of the arena, but then, like, his Mega Knight would kill my Princess, right? Okay, I don't know, but... That was okay defense. Like, the most important thing is that I did not lose my half of my tower in the first seconds of the match. And he will have Evolution of Skeletos, because we saw that Violet Shard above them. Okay, so he will have Evolution of Skeletos. We have that. We have Log for that, and we have also Princess. So we have two great responses. It shouldn't be that scary. And okay, he will just go for another Mega Knight. Like, what could I expect? I was hoping that maybe he will play, like, Musketeer at back or something like this, but no, it will not happen. And now I think that he tried to make prediction with that Ice Spirit. Maybe he was hoping that I will play like Skeletons, but that Mega Knight wouldn't break through my Inferno Tower anyway. So okay, that was just great defense. Let's play Ice Spirit, why not, and maybe Knight at back. Knight at back, and if I play Knight at back, maybe he will play also something behind his tower. Come on, I know you won't. Where is that Musketeer? Okay, maybe he'll not do that, and okay, I don't know, is he, like, did he just left, or... Okay, yeah, so we'll take that easy win, because our opponent just left the game, and maybe he was so frustrated that I defended his Mega Knight push so easily, or I don't know, maybe he just went for a dinner. Well, whatever there was the reason, we won this with a free crown, and now we won 3 matches in a row. Come on, baby, you are unstoppable today. Can we win all the games we play today? That's the question. I will try to do that. If I will be able to achieve it, it will be great, but... Okay, it might be really hard, because our opponent has got Royal Recruits Evolution, because we saw that chart, and we have Inferno Tower. It will not be really great defensive building against against Swarm, like he has got in his deck with Royal Recruits, Skeleton Barrel, and all the other stuff. But wait, somehow I defended all of that, and I took only, like, that Skeleton Barrel dev damage. And he just played Log. Okay, let's go with Goblin Barrel immediately. That might be one of our only chances to do that. Okay, but it didn't work really, because he played Goblin Gang. And he'll play also Wall Breakers, but okay, Princess stops that all, right? Okay, let's go. So now we have some Elixir advantage, like, Probably we have 2 or 3 elixirs more than our opponent. I think that I will go knight in front and let's go. Was that a prediction? I don't know. But now we'll kill that princess and try to make our princess lock on his tower. But wait, if I play something like this, maybe even Goblin Gang. I want our princess to hit his tower so bad, and okay, she died unfortunately. I thought that Goblin Gang will kill that that Dark Prince, but okay, it didn't happen. And at least we got some damage with our Spear Goblins, so you know, that's always great. And okay, he will go right now with Royal Recruit's Evolution. I think this is over. Like, there is legitimately no chance to defend that, because with all that spam, and I have also like Infernal Tower, Bomb Tower would be probably the best card in this situation, but okay. Once they lose their shields, they will start rushing on my tower, but wait, if we can freeze them... Oh no, but on that left side, that Dart Goblin and Musketeer... and Princess, sorry. Oh well, yeah, so I think that there are no hopes of winning this match, even if I would... Even if I would somehow break through with my Goblin Barrels and all the other cards, this is simply not possible to defend all of his attacks, because he will just play those Royal Recruits, supported with Skeleton Barrel, maybe also Princess Dart Goblin, and there is just no hopes of defending that. But maybe wait, like right now? Okay, I think that we'll take this tower, and if I can defend both of my towers... Wait, he's got... right now, he doesn't have the evolution of Royal Recruits, he has the regular ones. So wait, if I can defend that, only 25 seconds remaining, wait, and I need to also defend both towers at once. He played them. He played the Royal Recruits Evolution, but why did he do that behind his King Tower? I don't know if they will come here on time. Okay, we just need to defend that, come on. Come on, 7 seconds, I hope that we can do this. No, don't dash on my tower, no, no, no. 2, 1, let's go. With only 200 HP left. Whoa, and he sent us also well played, so I didn't expect him to be a nice player, and I also didn't expect to win that one. Wow. Sorry for all the screams, especially at the end, I got a little bit too excited, but seriously, I didn't expect to win that game. Today we proved that the deck from the past still can dominate on the arena, even against some swarm decks like in the last match, which I would never anticipate. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, you can subscribe to my channel to see all the content I have prepared for the future, and I will see you all next time.